ever wondered why some people seem to have a gift for music?
Have you ever wished that you could play by ear, sing in tune, improvise and jam?
You're in the right place. Time to turn those wishes into reality.
Welcome to the Musicality Podcast
with your host, Christopher Sutton.
Over the years, I've seen a lot of musicians make a lot of mistakes with ear training. There are a few mistakes that come up a lot more often than others, and one of those really common ones is what I call the ear training trap. In our recent episode with Brent Vaartstra from Learn Jazz Standards, we talked about his new ear training course, and one of the things I highlighted was that he's cleverly designed it to avoid this trap. Before we dive in and talk about the trap and how you can avoid it, let's take a quick moment to talk about what ear training is. At Musical U, we define ear training as any activity you do to improve your ear for music. That is a very broad definition, as it should be. But what we're going to be talking about today is the more traditional definition of ear training that most musicians would associate with the phrase, and that's doing dedicated exercises, drills, to recognize different elements in music by ear. Examples would be practicing recognizing the interval between a pair of notes, or listening to a sequence of chords and trying to identify what the progression is. There are loads of different areas where you can do useful ear training exercises, but with all of them, you're in danger of falling into the same trap. Let's start with an example. Jeff is a saxophone player who wants to improvise jazz. Jeff has heard that intervals are really important for having a good jazz ear, so he grabs an interval training app or maybe some practice MP3s, and he spends a few weeks dedicatedly putting in 20 minutes a day practicing. He makes some progress. After a few weeks, he can recognize a handful of interval types, ascending and descending. But Jeff is losing enthusiasm. He's glad to have made progress, but when he picks up his sax, he doesn't really feel any different about improvising. Jeff has fallen into the ear training trap. So what's gone wrong? Well, he has treated his ear training as an isolated activity. He's done well with the ear training itself, but he's been doing drills that aren't really connected with his instrument or the music he loves, and he hasn't had any way to make that connection. If you never relate ear training exercises to your actual musical life, ear training quickly feels pointless, and it becomes incredibly hard to keep up your motivation. And that's fair enough, because you're not really seeing any benefit from all your effort. So what's the solution? Well, naturally, it's to make sure your ear training efforts are connected to your musical life. In the new ear training course from Learn Jazz Standards, there is a section all about applying your new ear skills on your instrument. At Musical U, in our ear training roadmaps, we provide the dedicated training modules with those core ear training exercises, but then we always accompany them with recommended exercises you can do directly on your instrument to put it all into action. We also have a set of modules specifically about applying ear training to real musical tasks like playing by ear and improvising. And our instrument packs provide tutorial videos showing you exactly how to apply ear training on your specific instrument. The ear training trap is simple, and once you know about it, it's fairly easy to avoid. Unfortunately, the traditional ear training courses and methods leave you totally prone to falling into the trap. And in my experience, maybe 90% of musicians who pursue ear training do fall into the trap, and it leaves them thinking that ear training is difficult and pointless. Don't fall into the trap yourself. Now that you know about it, you can find ways to make sure you always connect your ear training to your real musical life. And of course, if you need guidance on doing that, we're always happy to help at Musical U. Before I wrap up, I do want to mention one other thing. Some musicians actually try so hard to avoid the trap, they end up falling into another one. I was just talking the other day to a professional bassist who runs a popular website teaching bass guitar, and he was telling me how after years of gigging, he had a really good ear, and he could happily sit in with a band and pick things up by ear. But he had never really done any ear training exercises. He just learned it gradually by repeated trial and error, playing his instrument year after year. Now, that's good, and clearly it served him okay. But I found myself wishing he had been shown a good way to do ear training. Because while the brute force, instrument-only approach does work, it really does take years of playing, probably at a semi-professional level, before you get a really solid ear. The beauty of ear training exercises is that they can dramatically accelerate that progress by quickly giving you the building blocks required to do all the practical musical tasks. If you don't give yourself those building blocks, it's a much slower journey. So that's another trap to be avoided, thinking that instrument practice alone will get you a good ear fast. Ear training is a powerful and efficient way to get good ears, but you mustn't fall into the trap of doing it isolated from your instrument and from your real musical life. And you should also try not to swing too far in the other direction and miss out on the fast progress that dedicated exercises and ear training practice can provide. I hope that whether you've never tried ear training before or you've tried it and fallen into the trap of doing it in isolation, this quick episode has helped show you this dangerous trap and how you can make sure you avoid it in the future.
Thank you for listening to the Musicality Podcast. This episode has ended, but your musical journey continues. Head over to musicalitypodcast.com, where you will find the links and resources mentioned in this episode, as well as bonus content exclusive for podcast listeners. That's musicalitypodcast.com.